I whitsun day in Huntly Toon, it's there I did agree. With bogies I don't care nae, it's 6 months for to fee. Tae drive his twa best horses, likewise his kirt and plume. And to tee a thing about the fell, that drift will I could do. Now Bogey had a daughter, whose name was Isabel. The flower o' her nation, there's nane her could excel. She had rosy cheeks and ruby lips, and hair darkest hue. She was neat, complete and handsome, and comely for to view. One day she went a rambling, and chose me for her guide. To take a pleasant walk with her, along by Kearney's side. I have slipped my arm about her waist, and tae the ground did slide. And it's there I've had my first bonnet, with the bell o' Bogey's side. The blackbird sang sae sweetly, the mavis sang sae shrill, and the chorus o' their song was, "There lies Bogey's bell." Among the weeds o' Kearney, upon the grassy green, then she and I rose up again, for fear we would be seen. Her 20 weeks had passed and gone, this lassie lost her bloom. Her rosy cheeks grew pale and wan, and she began to swoon. Ere 40 weeks had passed and gone, this maid brought forth a son. And I was quickly sent for, to see what could be done. Old Bogey heard my story, and cried, "I am undone. Since ye beguiled my doctor, my sorrows are begun." Ah, says old man, "Ye fell erect, and I hung my head in shame. I'll Mary Bell the morning, I'll give the bairn my name." But though I said I'd wed the lass, nana that would need it. Yeah, I'm nae a fitting match for Bell, nor she a match for ye. And he sent me back and down the road, with nae penny o' my fee. Say I, ye lads o' Huntly Toon, a land farewell to ye. And now she's married with a tinkler lad, whose name is Sutter John. He hawks his pans and ladles around by foggy lawn, and maybe she she's got a better match. Old Bogey cannot tell, but it's me was tame the maiden heat. Oh, Bogey.